Hey guys, so my birthday is the day after, so I'm on leave for the next 2 days, so I have some time to get grinding. So besides being my birthday, Christmas is fast approaching, so I thought it was quite apt to do a Christmas display. So here I have Yotsuba with Danbot. So Yotsuba is opening up a parcel with a teddy bear in it. So this is her Christmas gift, and then she's celebrating with Danbot. So something very festive. I'm going to do a variant picture in a bit, so stay tuned for that. Yeah, I had high hopes for this lamp, but it's just not cutting it. So I did this display, hoping that it'll be clearer because the Shocker Combat Man are black, but it's just not showing up very well. So I'm going to go revert to my usual mode of operation, and see how the pictures turn out. I hope they turn out much better. Was talking to Mindless about the Shocker Combat Man, so he was telling me that the significance of the coin in the finger, in the hands, I mean. So I thought I'll do one scene because I coincidentally had a Pac-Man arcade machine. So I did this scene where the Shocker Combat Man are kind of fighting over who's gonna play the Pac-Man arcade machine. So here I have one Combat Man holding a coin, fighting off the other Combat Man, and one has a mace and he's trying to get into the action. So just something different I'm trying out, so I hope you guys enjoy it. Decided to do one more Lobo picture. So here Lobo has in his phaser drawn, so he's trying to apprehend John Stewart. So this is the first time I'm featuring this John Stewart figure. It's actually a modded figure. I used the head for Black Panther previously, but now I'm using it back on his original body. So I'm just doing a bounty hunter picture. So I'm gonna do a variant in a bit, so stay tuned for that. Okay, here's my B-side picture with Amazo in the background. So Amazo is kind of floating over John Stewart, planning to deliver the killer blow. So I just thought it's a nice picture to do because Amazo is seldom featured, as is John Stewart. So I hope the pictures come out quite well. Mindless is really my muse. I was on WhatsApp with him this afternoon, and he inspired this idea. So I went to visit my friend at the hospital, had my birthday dinner, and then I'm back home. So here is my A side. So this is the classic Three Monkeys, but in a Shocker's version. So here you have see no evil, hear no evil, speak no evil. So I hope you guys enjoy this. I'm going to do a B side in a moment. So my camera on my smartphone started to act cranky. So there was some delay in taking pictures of this display as well as this video. So anyway, this is for the baby boomers up there. So you guys are from the 70s and 80s. So you probably may be more aware of what's going on here. So this is kind of my version of the Madonna Vogue video, striking a pose. So here, three Shocker Combat Men doing their thing. So it's a nice variation to the earlier display that I did. So just something I did for fun. I haven't really contributed to December so far, so I thought I'll pull out this Two-Face, one of my favorite DCUCs, Well, no, actually, this was from the DC Superheroes line, but he's one of my favorite, bat villain, bat rogue. So I thought I'll just do a display where he's kind of saying that DC has better storylines. So you kind of figure out why soon, because I'm going to do a B variant, a B side that explains this. So it's the flip side of this display. Okay, cool. I think I have the pictures that I want. So this is the B side I was talking about. So earlier, you know, kind of trying to depict that DC has better storylines. But here I'm giving a good example of Marvel having better toys. So I think it's quite apt to do this display. So I hope you guys enjoy it and agree with my views. Okay, this is a figure that I've had on ice for like I think more than half a year. The reason for that was that when this figure first came out, there were like probably a million pictures of him every single day. So I've put him off, you know, in terms of opening him up and doing a review and pictures until now. So, you know, recently it's been a pretty quiet season for me. Haven't really had much new figures. So I felt it was kind of time to take this guy out, and also I had some sudden inspiration to do a picture featuring this figure. So stay tuned for that display. Okay, upon opening the package, my initial thoughts. Wow, I mean the sculpt, crazy, the features, the props, the accessories, crazy. My reaction, I mean the in one statement, why can't they do this for all legends and for all selects? I have no bloody idea, because the funny thing is this figure costs about the same as what I paid for the Rhino. And the Rhino comes with nothing, it's just a figure. Whereas this guy comes with a ton of accessories and is pretty impressive. So now I can understand what the fuss was all about. So anyways, I'm going to do a display now. So stay tuned. In the end, I decided to only use the multiple heads that came with the select Venom. So you know, as the year comes to a close, I'd like to give my thanks to my mentor and muse, Mindless. So brother, this is dedicated to you. So just a very simple display I set up. So here I have the Sinister Six Spidey. Kind of just reading a Spider-Man comic. So on the cover is Venom, which is quite apt since I have Venom in the background. So this comic was actually made by Mindless, and then the spider sense effect was done by myself, and the rest are just props from different places. So yeah, like to give a shout out to all my buddies, my loyal followers, friends like Book, Mark G. Nolan, BD Earl, Adam Jordan, Rick Valdez, you know, who constantly gets me stuff for ACBA displays. Old buddies like Hector Calligan, so many names. Floyd Patterson, so and so forth. So sorry guys, whoever I may have left out from the shoutouts, but you know who you are. So thank you very much. An advance Merry Christmas to you. Keep grinding. Like, comment, subscribe to Marto. Okay, so I spent kind of half the day with Mindless. So we met first at CSC, and then followed by a quick trip to Dolls Inc. at Funan. So there's a story behind this Daft Punk SH Figuarts figures. So that was kind of this fiasco regarding these figs. So what happened was, I think it was about 6 months ago, I put a pre-deposit down for this pair. And then the shop that I put the pre-deposit with shut down. So Mindless being the fantastic brother he is, he hunted down the shop owner and he got me in touch with the the guys who could rectify this. So here I have my birthday present for myself, the pair of DJs. So here you have Emmanuel and Thomas. So I'm going to do some I'll probably do a review and a display of these figs in a moment, so stay tuned for that. So besides the Daft Punk figures, you know, I mentioned I was at CSC earlier with Mindless and Vic. So what I did was I picked up this bunch of penguins, this imitation Lego Batman with a Batarang, this grenade launcher, this PlayStation prop. And that's about it. That's what I picked up for today. So I'm just going to quickly do a display, a bunch of displays actually, and then let you guys take a look and comment. So when I bought this PlayStation console with the game casing, it was kind of a no-brainer. I wanted to do a fun picture for Simple Sunday. So I decided to use the TMNT figure. So just a bunch of props. So I think every now and then I just wanted to throw in some random stuff to see whether you guys are paying attention. Some Easter eggs. If you guys notice anything out of the ordinary or something that you recognize, yeah, just leave a comment to tell me that you notice, and then we will just have some form of interaction. So I hope you guys like this picture. Okay, this is another Simple Sunday display that I did. So it's just a vanilla pose. Crossbones holding on to a grenade launcher. So this is actually a 1/6 scale grenade launcher, but because Crossbones is such a big figure, it kind of works. So it's pretty nice to use with this figure. Probably won't work with any other figures. So sometimes you can use props from different scales. In this case, as you can see, it does work. So sometimes you just have to keep your eyes peeled to look out for some bargains that you can use. In this case, the grenade launcher wasn't that cheap, but I've been searching for a weapon that I can use with Crossbones for a while, so it kind of works in this case. Okay, so I kind of added something to the display. So I added the three grenade shells to his vest to add some realism. So I think it works pretty well. So I think from this angle you can see pretty dope, nice picture. So yeah, sometimes it's small things like that, small things like this that makes a difference. So exercise some creativity. Pretty simple, you know, I just holding them up onto his vest with some blue tack. You know, I know you guys like to use wax, but we don't really have cheese wax over here, so blue tack works as well. It's a no-brainer, really. So, who do you use penguins with? Of course, the penguin, who is the Batman rogue. And here I have Mr. Freeze joining him. So, they are kind of looking at a bunch of penguins. So, I think, you know, in a way, it's kind of like, you know, James Bond villains, you know, using ridiculous weapons of mass destruction. So in this case, I can imagine penguin introducing killer penguins with freaking lasers on their back. So one of them actually kind of does has this contraption on the back. So I think that's pretty realistic in a way. Yeah, I was with Mindless and Tandy at Funan yesterday. So we came across this the snake figure. My memory fails me. I can't remember which computer game that character is from. So anyways, we were looking at the figures, and Mindless was I saw the packaging had snake hiding in the box. I asked Mindless what that was about, and it turns out that that's a tactic that Snake uses to disguise himself. So I thought I'll do a display where, you know, Deadpool does the same, and Wolverine is kind of puzzled. So, you know, Deadpool is kind of the only character who can pull this off, so I thought it would be fun to do this display. I decided to redo the Daft Punk picture. So here I'm using a trance concert in the backdrop. I think this effect is much better than the one I did previously. So sometimes your initial concept doesn't work, you just have to keep grinding and come up with alternatives. So whilst I'm talking, the figures are kind of quivering, so I'm going to take some more pictures before dismantling this display. So I thought I'll just give a spoiler alert. So in case you guys have never read Yosuba, you might want to mute this portion or skip this portion altogether. So anyways, those who have read Yosuba will know that Danbot is actually a school project made by this girl called Miura. So anyways, Yosuba doesn't know that Danbot is actually just a piece of cardboard made to look like a robot. So anyways, in the manga, there's actually a scene where Yosuba gets a shock because she finds Danbot dismantled. Kind of like this. This is actually the model inspired by that scene. But in that scene, the Danbot is actually kept in Miura's room. But here I'm doing a storeroom scene. So yeah, I think it works. It's kind of cute. So I thought I'll get this scene done since I have this kit model anyways. Yeah, so it's kind of a start of another weekend. So I'm kind of halfway through my weekend because I'm probably like 12 hours ahead of you guys. But anyways, enough about my current status. So I kind of wanted to do this picture. You know, Blob is one of my favorite baths of all time. So, you know, I kind of combined a few props. So I had the Lobo 3D glasses. I had this cone that I made myself. And then there's this popcorn prop from Stitch. So I just kind of put everything together. You know, sometimes if you can't get the height correct, you just have to make do by using other props to prop things up. So yeah, just a simple display I thought I'll do. You know, I'm kind of a movie buff. So I thought this was quite apt. You know, I did watch Hobbit Part 2 just a few days ago. I felt it was a bit draggy, but otherwise a pretty decent movie. So yeah, I'm going to do some editing, you know, posting pictures as usual. Going to publish Mato, this episode of Mato. So enjoy the episode and like, comment, subscribe. Definitely there'll be more Mato coming up. So this is probably my last episode for 2013. So Merry Christmas to you guys and have a wonderful 2014. So definitely there'll be more Mato coming in 2014. Look forward to talking to you guys soon.
Crispy.